So now we are going to start Clemmensen reduction. In this reaction, a carbonyl compound is reduced to alkanes. So Clemmensen reduction reduces an aldehydes and ketones to alkanes. So carbonyl compound converts to CH2 group. That is, now aldehyde gets converted to RCH3 and ketones get converted to RCH2R. It cannot reduce the carbon-carbon double bond or carbon-carbon triple bond. And this is an acid catalyzed reaction. So the reagent is zinc amalgam in conch HCl. Zinc amalgam in conch HCl. And there is a simultaneous dehydration of alcohol also takes place. Now we will see few examples of Clemmensen reduction. Aldehyde when treated with zinc amalgam HCl forms RCH3, that is alkane plus water. Suppose we have ethanol. So with ethanol when reduced in presence of zinc amalgam HCl, we get ethane plus water. Suppose we have acetone, that is propanone. Propane when treated with zinc amalgam HCl, we get propane plus water. Suppose we have acetophenone, also called methyl phenyl ketone, acetophenone, then it forms ethyl benzene, then it forms ethyl benzene. Suppose we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we have cyclohex 3-in-1-one treated with zinc amalgam HCl, we get cyclohexene. The double bond remains unaffected. Suppose we have a molecule that is 5-hydroxypentane-2-one. Here, during Clemmensen reduction, what happens? This ketone is reduced to a alkane, and similarly here dehydration happens and one molecule of water is released, so here a double bond comes, so 5-hydroxypentane-2-one forms hex-2-in. Now alpha beta unsaturated ketones, this is the alpha carbon, this is the beta carbon. So alpha beta unsaturated ketones, what happens in this case, this also gets converted to CH2 and this also gets reduced. So alpha beta unsaturated ketones undergo reduction of both the olefinic and carbonyl groups. So that is very important. So alpha beta unsaturated ketones undergo reduction of both the alkene as well as the carbonyl group. Now alpha and beta keto acids are generally not reduced. Alpha and beta keto acids are generally not reduced, but other keto acids are reduced by Clemmensen reduction. Suppose we have a 1,3 diketones, it gives exclusively monoketones, means one of the ketonic group is reduced, other remains here, and there is a rearrangement also. Now we are going to see one example. It is a gamma ketonic acids. So here reduction of this ketonic group takes place. So it is 4-oxo-4-phenylbutanoic acid. When it is undergoing Clemmensen reduction, then this reduction of this 4-oxo group takes place and it forms 4-phenylbutanoic acid. Suppose you are given a compound like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3-hydroxy cyclopentane carbaldehyde, So in this case what happens, this is reduced and this is substituted with chlorine. So the product formed is 1, 2, 3, That is 1,2,3. 1-chloro-3-methyl-cyclopentane. So that is the product formed. Similarly, if you have 3-nitrobenzaldehyde, so this nitro group get reduced to amino group. So it forms 3-methyl-aniline, and this is your 3-nitrobenzaldehyde. So from 3-nitrobenzaldehyde, you get 3-methyl-aniline. Now let's see the mechanism of Clemmensen reduction. We are considering a ketone. H plus is there, which comes from the acid. So what happens? This shifts here, this gives here. So it forms a carbocation. Now zinc donates the electron to this carbocation carbon. So it gets a negatively charged. Now proton again attacks. So it forms a protonated alcohol. Elimination of one molecule of water takes place to form a carbocation. Again zinc donates the electron to this carbocation. Again proton attacks. So when the electron is donated, zinc comes out as Zn2+. So here again proton attacks, so we get the alkane. So I will repeat this again. So we will consider a ketone. So this electron shifts here, oxygen binds with the proton, so it forms a protonated, we can't say it is a protonated alcohol, it is a carbocation with an OH group. Zinc donates the electron to this positively charged carbon, it gets an extra electron. Now proton attacks here, so proton, site of attack of proton is here also, and it binds with the O also here. So it forms a protonated alcohol. Protonated alcohol loses one molecule of water to form a carbocation. Again zinc gives the electron to this positively charged carbon. It becomes negatively charged carbon and it takes up a proton to form alkane. So this is the mechanism of Clemmensen reduction. Now we are going to discuss Wolff-Kistner reduction. This is another method by which carbonyl compounds can be reduced to alkanes. So here we are seeing one aldehyde is there. We are treating with hydrazine. So it forms hydrazone. This hydrazone is treated with alkali and in presence of glycol, heated, it gives alkane and nitrogen gas is released. Suppose if we take propanone. Propanone is a ketone. Treated with hydrazine, KOH glycol heated, we get propane. This reaction is called Wolff-Kistner reduction. Now we are going to see the reaction of carbonyl compound with HI and red phosphorus. HI and red phosphorus is a very strong reducing agent. So if we see ethanol, if we treat ethanol with HI red phosphorus, we get ethane, water and I2. If we treat ethanol with HI and red phosphorus, ethane plus water plus I2 is formed. This reaction takes place at 423 Kelvin. This reaction takes place at 423 Kelvin. Now, if we treat propanone, if we treat propanone with HI and red phosphorus at 423 Kelvin, we get propane plus water plus I2. Now we are going to discuss Merwin-Pondorf-Verley reduction. This is the reverse of Oppenauer oxidation. So what happens? We take a ketone and treat with aluminium isopropoxide in presence of isopropyl alcohol. Isopropyl alcohol is also called rubbing alcohol. So when ketone is treated with aluminium isopropoxide in presence of isopropyl alcohol, we get secondary alcohol. This reaction is called MPV reduction, Merwin-Pondorf-Verley reduction, which is the reverse of Oppenauer oxidation.